السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. أهلا وسهلا ومرحبا بكم يا عبد الله يا أمة الله. الله سبحانه وتعالى states in the noble Quran, كل نفس ذائقة الموت, every single soul will taste death. يا عبد الله, no doubt the loss of a parent is a massive blow to any human being, whether it be Muslim or whether it be non-Muslim. With regards to the Muslim, as the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam has stated, that the believer, all of his affairs are good. If it's tough times, he has sabr, then walhamdulillah, this is good for him. And when it's good times, he makes shukr, and walhamdulillah, that's good for him. With regards to the loss of a parent or any other close relative, be it a husband, be it a wife, be it a child, Allahu musta'an, then a few patterns that we should take note of, insha'Allah. Number one, this is the qadr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Every single one of us, this is the journey that we have to face and we have to go through. Do we not want to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Do we not want to enter into paradise? Yes, we do. And so we have to go through death's door. Number two, ya Abdullah, with regards to the funeral preparations, with regards to the events, with regards to the matters surrounding the death, we should stick to the sharia of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We should not involve ourselves in innovations, involve ourselves in practices, cultural practices, etc. Rather stick to the sunnah, for verily it is the best. Number three, ya Abdullah, no doubt this is emotional turmoil when someone passes away. Have people around oneself. If you know of someone who has lost a father, lost a mother, offer themselves a shoulder, offer them a shoulder, offer them time that they can speak about this loss. Many a times we bottle this in, and in reality it comes out at times in the wrong way. Rather speak to somebody. No doubt it is natural, we lost a father, lost a grandfather, lost a mother who was with us for our entire lives, Allahu musta'an. It is no doubt a massive loss, so speak to someone. And no doubt, getting over this turmoil, getting over this emotional roller coaster might not take just a week, might not take 2 days or 5 days, it might be months. But subhanAllah, with time, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala, all matters heal. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam lost a son. He lost more than one a son. He lost Qasim, he lost Ibrahim, he lost Abdullah. He lost Ruqayya, he lost Kulthum, and he lost Zainab. When he was tearing and they asked him, even you cry, O Muhammad, what did he say? He said that, إِنَّ الْعَيْنَ لَتَدْمَعْ وَإِنَّ الْقَلْبَ لَيَحْزَنْ وَمَا نَقُولْ إِلَّا مَا يُرْضِي رَبَّنَا. That's the eye tears, the heart is saddened, but we only say what is pleasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so crying, tearing, all of these matters are fine. This is how we overcome this great loss that one has faced. We also remind ourselves, myself number one, and the viewers, that when someone passes away, we say, إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. The first group of people we remember are who? Are ourselves. Verily we belong to Allah, and verily we will return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, one could do many a deed to benefit one's parent. One can give charity, one can, for example, perform the hajj, one can pay off the debts, and one should pay off their debts, insha'Allah. There's a debate with regards to recitation of the noble Quran. One can give sadaqah, whatever good deed the child does, and the child was taught this by the parents, insha'Allah, then all of this is sadaqatun jariyah for the parent, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ease our losses. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us khair in this world and in the hereafter. And those who have lost parents, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant them jannatul firdaus and fill their qabr with noor, insha'Allah. Jazakumullahu khairan. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.